We start with the name of Allah. All praise is due to Him, and we ask Allah Ta'ala to raise the rank of our Prophet Muhammad and to protect his nation from that which he fears for them. Dear brothers in Islam, our khutbah for today is about the second last Prophet, Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Allah Ta'ala sent Prophet Isa, Jesus, as the messenger before Prophet Muhammad. He was one of the five best messengers of Allah, called Ulul Azm, those with the highest status, who were the most patient. Prophet Isa alayhi salam was the son of Maryam, the daughter of Imran, from the sons of Israel. Prophet Isa, as all the prophets, was truthful in what he conveyed from Allah. And although today we follow the Sharia of Prophet Muhammad, Muslims respect, love, and believe in Prophet Isa alayhi salam. Ibn Jarir and others narrated that one day Maryam alayha salam, the mother of Isa, ran out of water. She asked her cousin Yusuf, the son of Yaqub the carpenter, to go with her to get some. He declined, saying he had his sufficiency for that day. So Maryam went to fetch water alone. There she found Jibreel, whom Allah Ta'ala had sent to her in the shape of a man. Thinking he was a human being who might harm her, she asked refuge with Allah from him. Jibreel alayhi salam told her, "I am the messenger of your Lord to you. I was sent to you to give you a pious child who is pure from sins." Maryam told him, "How would I have a son when I have no husband? I am certainly not an adulteress or a fornicator." Jibreel alayhi salam told her, "Creating a son without a father is an easy matter to Allah. Allah will make him a sign to the people and an indication of the power of Allah. He will send him as a mercy from him and an endowment to everyone that follows him and believes in him. Creating him is a matter Allah Ta'ala willed and destined, so it will not be blocked or changed." Jibreel alayhi salam blew the soul of Isa into Maryam, and Isa's soul entered into her womb. Maryam became pregnant with Isa alayhi salam. When the signs of her pregnancy became apparent, Maryam went away from her people. The pangs of birth led her to the trunk of a dead palm tree. Out of her shyness from the people and fearing they would accuse her of having done something wrong, she wished she was dead and not a trace of her could be found. While in that state, Jibreel called her, comforting her. He told her that Allah Ta'ala made a small river under her from which she could drink, and should she shake the trunk of the dead palm tree next to her, it will turn green and moist dates would fall down for her to eat from and be nourished. Jibreel told her that if confronted by her people questioning her regarding her son, to tell them she made a vow not to talk to any human for that day. That day Maryam gave birth to her son Isa alayhi salam. 40 days later, she carried him back to her people. They accused her of having fornicated. In response, Maryam pointed to her son, wanting the people to address him. They were angered by her gesture and thought that she was making fun of them and mocking them by asking to speak with a 40-day-old baby lying in a small cradle. Indeed, Isa spoke by the will of Allah, what means, as mentioned in the Holy Quran, "I am a slave of Allah. He will reveal the book to me and make me a prophet, and I shall be blessed wherever I am. In the rules that will be revealed to me, there will be a special attention given to prayers and zakat. Allah predestined that I will be kind to my mother and not a tyrant with a bad ending. Peace was on me the day I was born. Peace will be on me on the day I will die and on the day I am raised alive again." In the end, we ask Allah Ta'ala to assemble us with Prophet Isa and all the prophets and messengers on the day of judgment, and to admit us to paradise. Ameen.